this alliance is a very good, significant step by FAO, bringing people together, make that awareness, because indifference has caused the whole problem. We are indifferent. So hopefully, with the presence of the Nobel laureates, some awareness will be created beyond the existing awareness and excite the people that, yes, it can be doable. It's a doable thing. Anything, anytime we can overcome this hunger issue, we have enough of food, enough of ability to reach out to food to the people. We can do instantaneously almost if you want to do that. But our mind is not there. My goal is zero poverty. And I've been talking about zero poverty for many, many years. And I talk about putting poverty in the museum. It doesn't belong to human society. It's forcefully, we have done that in a way we didn't understand what we are doing, or we are simply callous about it. We don't care who does what. That's what caused poverty. And we created a system which encourages, which pushes people into poverty rather than taking them out. So poverty has become a sort of a prison for them. So all we have to do is to fix the system and people will be out. There's nothing wrong with the poor people. Poor people as good as anybody, any other human being. They're creative, they're enterprising, they want to take care of their children, they have their goals, their ambitions, their dreams of their life. They cannot do that because of the system will not let them come out. So that way, I mean, in the alliance, I'm trying to bring other people in the alliance. When I'm invited to join it, I'm already there. You can't stop me. It's all integrated. It's all linked with each other. These are not separate issues. We simply see it from different kind of lenses. That this we see the women empowerment, this we see the food security, this we see something else. This is all linked. Poverty and peace is linked. Hunger and poverty is linked. And they link to the peace. You cannot have peace leaving behind all the people, poor people and hungry people. You can't have peace. So there's no peace without food security for everybody. You cannot have food security without having peace. So this have to coexist together. You take one, other gets disrupted automatically. It could continue to happen. So we have to make sure we ensure peace. Again, it's something that we have to come out of our own feeling that this is needed for the whole world. We don't need to, don't go and cause all these problems by creating conflicts and wars and all the kind of balances that creates terrorism that's created and so on. So how to address that kind of thing? And at the same time, take care of the hunger, take care of malnutrition, take care of poverty, so that we don't go into terrorism, we don't go into conflict. Financial system is the most concrete thing. When we talk about food, sometimes you forget that these are related issues. How can you go to the food if you don't have the money? They have plenty of food in the market, but I can't buy it. But I don't have an income. So I can just watch food in front of me, but I cannot touch it. I cannot put it in my empty stomach. So that's where you need to create income. An income is not something falls on your lap automatically. You have to work, and you're ready to work. You're not shy of working. You're ready to work. Poor people work very hard, but they don't get anything out of that. So you bring the money to them, suddenly their work becomes more meaningful. We have the capacity to solve all the human problems that we see around us. That's what the human beings are all about, creative power. We are packed with unlimited creative power, but we don't use it. We use it only for money making. Taking a job and working for them.